greetings, folks. Today on my bench is a Waltham Model 1888 Grade 28 16 size open face pocket watch. A quick trip to the pocket watch database tells us that this watch was made in 1898 and a total of 78,110 units were produced. Nothing really special about this piece, it's a 15 jewel pendant set 3/4 plate movement. Overall, this watch is in a very good condition for its age. The case will definitely need a bit of a polish. The case back has a few dents, which we can address, and the crystal is made of acrylic. I'm pretty sure that this crystal has been replaced before because of its very good condition given its age. However, it does have a few scuffs, which I'll deal with later as well.
Hey! Want to hear the most annoying sound in the world?
The reason why I bought this watch is because of the Breguet Moonhands. To me, they have that classy clock tower look which always appealed to me. The dial has a few hairlines, but that's understandable. As far as the watch's current performance goes, it loses about 155 seconds per day, with an amplitude of 150 degrees and a beat error of 2.4 milliseconds. Unfortunately, I forgot to film this prior to working on the watch. The disassembly process is a good way to find any existing faults and get a good idea of the movement's overall condition. Here I'm checking for the mainspring barrel side shake potentially caused by wear and tear. Fortunately, none was found in this movement. There are excessive amounts of oil on this watch from the previous service. The top and bottom balance jewels are capped. The hole jewel and the cap jewel both get cleaned in lighter fluid. Thank you. One of my biggest OCD-driven pet peeves are bad-looking screws, and this watch has some that have seen their share of screwdrivers. Using a pin vise to hold the screws, I remove the marks caused by screwdrivers by polishing them on a 1500 grit sandpaper. That's followed by deep polishing with a buffing and polishing compound. During the disassembly, I had noted that the winding stem was in a poor aesthetic condition. I placed it in a vise and then, using a 1500 grit sandpaper cut into thin strips, I removed the rust and dry lubricants while at the same time giving it a nice new finish. Thank you. In order to polish the pivots on the balance wheel, the hairspring needs to be removed. I also like to remove the roller table in case my file slips so that I don't end up damaging the impulse jewel. I don't have a pivot gauge, and I don't quite trust the one that came with my J-cut tool. It seems to be a little bit worn. So to err on the side of caution, I double-check the size of the pivots on my micrometer. And here are the pivots for the third wheel after they've been polished. Note the gouging left by the teeth of the fourth wheel after more than a century of constant friction while engaging the gear of the third wheel as seen here. The same damage can be seen on the gear of the fourth wheel, left by the constant friction of the teeth from the third wheel. And here are the balance pivots prior to polishing. They were in a horrendous condition, and since I do not have a replacement balance staff, I had to rescue this one. I do not have footage of it after it had been polished, but the time grapher will not lie. I also inspect the teeth of the escape wheel as well as the rest of the wheel train to look for chips or cracks. Fortunately, none were found. Here, we're taking a closer look at the pallet stones. They appear to be in a very good condition, and I suspect that these are not original. Since I had to strip the balance wheel of all its components prior to polishing the pivots, I might as well check for poise. The hairspring, the roller table, and the pallet fork get dipped in lighter fluid in order to clean them and protect the shellac from dissolving, which can happen when immersed in other cleaning agents, including alcohol. Thank you. Alright, I think I'm going to end the part 1 of this restoration right here. Thanks for watching, and please come back for part 2. Cheers!